This episode is brought to you by Paramount Plus. Ewan McGregor stars as Count Alexander Rostov in A Gentleman in Moscow, the new limited series based on the best-selling novel. Stream it with the Paramount Plus with Showtime plan. Visit ParamountPlus.com to try it free.
Let's get it. I know YouTube wants. Okay. Hey. How y'all doing? Come on in. I'm live on Facebook. I'm live on Instagram. I'm live on Big O, and I'm live on YouTube, and I'm streaming from Spotify and Pandora. So if you're tuning in, come on in. Let's get it popping. Y'all already know what time it is.
It's time
for the Couch Chronicles. Where there ain't no fucking limits. Limits.
Every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday from 8 Central Time, you don't never want to miss a couch. Trust me. It ain't no fucking limits. I said none.
I know you feel like you had enough. You hate to lose someone you love, especially when it's someone you trust. I know it hurts, I know. To find out some of you wrong, be the main people doing you wrong. You really don't know where to turn. Who knows, who cares, I don't. And now you probably think it's a lie, but really you gon' be alright. All the pain that you feel inside is motivation for changing your life. Cause everybody got a dark cloud waiting on the rain to come down. Make you feel like not coming outside today. But if you're looking on the bright side, then all you gotta do is smile and watch the dark clouds fade away.
Yeah.
y'all don't know, if y'all have never heard that song, it's from my first album, Scars and a Diamond. It's called Smile for Me. Now, I really felt like it was a good song to be playing right now. I got something in my fucking eye, and I really hate that. Anyways, actually, I'm about to use y'all, because I know y'all can see. Oh, I do see it. Okay. Okay. Anyways, so today is Breast Cancer Talk on the Couch. Breast Cancer Awareness Month is this whole month. So if you know anybody that has breast cancer, that is a survivor from breast cancer, and want to talk about it, you are more than welcome to come to the Couch. I got a story of my own to talk to you guys about. So just bear with me. Bear with me. Welcome to the Couch if you're just now tuning in. If you're watching on Instagram, make sure that you share the live. If you're watching on Facebook, you can still share the live. If you're watching on YouTube, hit the like button. And I think you can still share the live. Okay, you can share the live any and everywhere. The next song that I play, I will be sharing the live myself. I do got some good informative things to tell you guys today. It's not just titties is out. Although, I do appreciate you guys for coming for the titties. But, Breast Cancer Awareness Month, we have to make people aware of breast cancer awareness. Because that's how a lot of people, it gets so bad because they don't check. And a lot of times they don't check because what? They don't have insurance. Or they feel like their insurance doesn't cover it. Well, I got some things to tell y'all. But before we do that, one, happy birthday to all the Libras that's out there. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Because it's your season still. Also, shout out to all the survivors that's out there right now. And I do want to give a moment of silence for those that have lost their lives from breast cancer. I know some of y'all probably think it's weird, but I always like to do a moment of silence for those that we've lost, whether it was from breast cancer, whether it was from gun violence, no matter what it was from, that we need to acknowledge our loved ones that we lost. We need to acknowledge the ones that's gone. You feel me? We need to acknowledge that. We want to be acknowledged now, don't we? Acknowledged now while we're alive. So why not? Don't forget about I don't know about y'all, but one of my biggest fears is to not be remembered when I pass away. So I'm sure that was probably one of theirs. So I always think, well, what if that was one of theirs? So I do want to remember them. I do want to give them a moment of silence. I do want to give them thanks. I do want to give them a praise because, hey, you are remembered. So if you guys see this, if you just so happen to see this video and you can get... And you know, and you have a name, drop a name in the comment. If you see this video, drop a name of a survivor, drop a name of someone that's lost, drop a name of yourself if you're a survivor yourself. Drop names. My mom is a survivor. I'm going to get into that story a little bit later. So this whole month, like I said, is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. So this might not be the first time you see my titties out. You never know. You might see my titties for the rest of the month. You never fucking know. So, but obviously I have people that watch from all over. My cousin just told me today that he was going to disown me if I got on the couch today with my titties out. I was like, cousin, my titties is going to be out, bruh. Like, regardless if you think they're not going to be out, they're going to be out. And hey, and my wife is in 100% agreement because... Hello, she's a woman as well. Breast cancer is very serious, not just in our community. Did you know that men could get breast cancer as well? Did you know that? All I'm saying is this. We have to make people aware, and sometimes you have to be drastic to make them aware. Sometimes you do. do what you gotta do, but watch my shoes. Anyways, the mic on the couch has still been going crazy. I don't have a challenger for this Friday. So if y'all not busy tomorrow, I do have some openings. The mic on the couch is donation only. I got the beat all provided by, exactly, MAV.GD on Instagram. Make sure y'all tap in with him while he doing deals as well. Listen, the mic on the couch, I'm going to make sure that I edit your video very good. Hey, shout out to everybody that's watching on Facebook. Shout out to Susie Yohola. Shout out to Uncle Groovy. Shout out to everybody. I see you. I see you in the comments. Shout out to everybody that's watching on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, listening on Spotify, Pandora. Shout out to my cousin that just disowned me today because I'm on the couch with my titties out. Love you, cousin. Again. So, the mic on the couch. If you are interested, please hit me up. You are more than welcome to hit the mic on the couch. If you out of town, no worries. I'm doing something for people that's out of town as well. The only thing is I won't be able to edit your video if you don't send me a video. So you got to send me your video. October 16th starts Mental Health Talk on the Couch. If you are brave enough to talk about your story, you are more than welcome again to come sit on this couch, or you can join in on the live. Anybody that joins in on the live, please remember to mute your mics. Mute your mics unless you are talking to yourself. Please. I'm so sorry. I just seen you. Make sure that you mute your mic when you come on up because it affects other people's sound. And it sounds really distorted. In case you have never been a viewer watching.
Hey, what's good, bro?
Hey.
Ready to free the nymph.
Yes. Yes. Fuck yes. We're doing it on the motherfucking couch. Period. So, it is breast cancer awareness on the couch. Yes, I know that's right. Ashton on the motherfucking couch with his breast out as well. So this is what we're doing. If you want to join, go ahead and cover on up and let's get on up. It's the Couch Chronicles. And it ain't no fucking limits. Question from the Couch does post every week. If you guys have not been tuning in to a question from the couch, you guys need to start tuning in. Start tuning in to the couch, period. You never know what might happen on the couch. You never know who you might find on the couch, what you might hear on the couch, you never know. So you have to keep tuning in to the couch. Couch Chronicles No Limits on Spotify, Pandora, THA Couch on Facebook and TikTok. Couch Chronicles No Limits on Instagram and my main YouTube Instagram and my .com, which is THA Real JANELL. I got another song for y'all. And this song is actually going to be on my new album that's going to be dropping. Now, I do have some bad news, but you just never know. Just bear with me. I don't know if I'm going to be dropping my new album in December. It might be in January. So please, please, please just stay tuned. Bear with me. But this next song that I'm about to play. Yeah, we are. This next song that I'm about to play is from my new album, and this one is called Cloudy Days. Again, like I said, it is breast cancer awareness on the couch. If you have a story about breast cancer awareness, if you're a survivor, if you know somebody that is a survivor, or you want to talk about it and share your story, you are more than welcome to come up. If you want to support, come on up. It's the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. Let's get into Cloudy Days. If you're watching on YouTube, hit the like button. If you're watching on Facebook, share the live. If you're watching on Instagram, share the live.
It's gonna be hard, but you're gonna be okay. And do not give up even if you make the same mistake. Yeah, it's tough. Some just try to get your head right. And when you were searching for some answers, and you was dead right. Yeah, you was. I know they try to make you think that you was crazy. Know you were, know you was. Know you were. Now every time you come around, you just be scoping. Don't be saying, I'll keep my mouth.
walls and not just listen. We've never been on the same, you can say we're different. It's a hard pill to swallow when there's no chaser. So go ahead and crush it. Let me take a toast with your eyes. Some days it's cloudy, after another days. You can choose wrong or you can fix your way. Life's too short to be playing games. But if you sure you gon' make a change, I know that you try hard and you gon' be okay. Please don't give up, cause I promise you gon' find your way. After the storm is over, you see it wasn't all for nothing. You see that it wasn't all for nothing.
On my next album that's gonna be dropping in January, we're just gonna say January just to keep it safe. That song is called Cloudy Days. That's actually gonna be the intro to my next album that's dropping. Hey, shout out to your guy One Eye in the motherfucking building, Pirate Ship Radio 103.5, the hottest radio station in Oklahoma City. If you don't know who he is, then you better stay tuned and get in touch with this man, because I'm telling you, listen. This is the man that you need to be knowing. If you don't know who he is, if you ain't gave him his flowers, you must not be somebody. You really ain't. I'm just saying. Y'all, if you didn't already get a chance, share the live. Let your peoples know. If you know anybody that's a survivor, let them know that we love them from the couch. We sending all positive vibes, love, and energy their way. October the 17th, the couch will be following up with... I don't know if you guys watched the gun violence, Stop the Gun Violence, the story, which is the story from the victims' families, what they're going through, how they're handling the situation, and how the judicial system is handling everything. The first episode aired September the 19th, so make sure that you go back and rewatch it if you didn't get a chance to rewatch it, because I will be keeping up with the case. The next court date will be October the 17th. So the couch will be there. I'm going to do everything that I can to ask questions. I'm going to talk to the lawyers if I can. I'm going to talk to everybody that I can. Thank you so much. Oh, wow. Yes, I'm so sorry to hear that. So if you guys, please keep in touch. Keep watching, because I'm taking this journalism seriously. I'm going to college for it. And, like, I really want to do this. It's not just about the podcast. It's about taking it to a whole nother level. And it's about, you know, getting to know a story deeper than what's on the surface, or deeper than what they're just telling you in the newspapers. So I'm going to be one of the ones I'm going to be like, hey, y'all going to be like, damn, is that Oprah? No, this is Notebook. Okay, but this is Janelle. And I'm going to be doing everything that I can to get us the best story. I'm trying to get to the truth. I don't take sides. I listen. That's it. I listen to both sides. And that's just what I do. Thank you so, so much. I definitely appreciate everybody on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, Spotify, Pandora. Let's keep it going. October the 28th, Laylas Social presents Hoochie Halloween Costume Party. Now, you don't want to miss it. I also just finished recording today a custom song, a theme song for the party. I do have tickets on deck. So if you guys are looking to come and you're in Oklahoma City, I have tickets on deck. I will be performing and I will also be a judge. So please come dress your best. You don't have to dress. Listen, men, I'm not saying come dress like a hoochie. Let me take that back. For the men that have been, transforming this year, please feel free to be your true self for Halloween. I will be judging at the Halloween costume party. So make sure that if you would like a ticket, tap in with me. And I will be doing a ticket giveaway. Actually, I'm going to do 5 tickets to give away. Actually, 6. Yeah, because it got to be couples. You know what I'm saying? You can't be just going without your friends. So you got to have a couple. Anyways, keep following the pages. Follow everybody that's in the live. It's all about love, support, good vibes, positive energy. And if you would like to share your story about breast cancer, please, please feel free to come up on the live. You are more than welcome. I do want to give a little story about my breast cancer story. It's not about myself. It's about my mother. My mother is a 26-year breast cancer survivor. And honestly, it affected me growing up as well as my mom. Because I was a kid 26 years ago. Seeing the turmoil, the trauma, my mom just trying to keep it together for me, you know, to keep it together for the family. It was just watching the mental breakdown, the insecurities, the ups and downs that comes from, you know, going through treatment and, you know, and not having a breast, you know, and for a woman, our hair is our glory. Everything that we already have on us is our glory. So for a piece of us to get taken away, such as your breast, I can only imagine what it could do to somebody, you know, to a woman, to any woman. And to watch my mom, it was very emotional. It was times where I cried and I didn't even know, fully understand actually what I was crying for, or what I just knew that my mom was missing a piece of her, and I didn't fully understand at a young age what exactly was the reason that my mom had to get her breast removed. Until I got older, did I start realizing that, oh my God, like, my mom had breast cancer. Like, my mom survived. Like, my mom lost her breast behind this sick-ass fucking disease. And I don't expect someone to go through that. And I'm not gonna lie, I don't expect them to be the nicest person in the world. I don't expect them to, you know, and I wouldn't be mad if they were rude sometimes, if sometimes they lashed out. I wouldn't be mad about it. All I can do is understand, or have some type of understanding, because that's a piece of you that is missing. A piece of you that is missing. That had to be taken away, even though you fought very hard to keep it, to keep your strength, to keep your sanity. And then to end up losing a piece of you, but not losing the battle, but losing a piece of you, but still surviving, it still can do something to your mental. You know, there's people that have lost, like, you know, limbs that's missing, legs, arms, ears, eyeballs. Imagine how they feel mentally. Imagine what they go through mentally. So, you know, for a woman, especially if they're, you know, if they're trying to have kids and they want to breastfeed, they can't breastfeed because one of them is gone. Or what if they had a double mastectomy and they only had none. So it's a lot, right? Hey, what up, though, Lance? It's a lot that they go through mentally, physically, emotionally. So again, breast cancer awareness today on the couch. I'm not saying I'm going to blast y'all with the titties every time. I don't want to overwhelm y'all. No. But I do want to keep you guys aware. And sometimes, like I said, to keep you aware, I gotta be drastic. Sometimes you gotta be drastic to get somebody's attention on things that's really, really serious. Because guess what? Sometimes it'll just go in one ear and out the other. They'll just be listening and looking and just be like. But sometimes whenever you looking, hey, how you doing? And you looking and you ain't got no choice but to keep looking. then you all of a sudden start listening. You hear me? And then you don't want to stop listening. I'm just saying. You know, I remember my mom just being so strong. I was like, how the fuck are you so strong? That's where I get it from. You know, shout out to all the strong survivors. Shout out to all the weak survivors. Seriously, because it ain't easy to be strong. And it's nothing wrong with being weak sometimes. But don't be so weak that you give up. And I don't mean it in a disrespectful way. I mean that in the most respectful way. Because we are rooting for you. We are standing for you. We are here. We are showing you that we are supporting. I definitely support. I'm a big supporter of breast cancer. My mom is a survivor. And I don't have to talk to my mom today, tomorrow. My mom is a survivor. And I'm going to honor that, period. You know, for those that's just tuning in, let me go ahead and say this. Thank you so much, first of all. If you're just now tuning in, it's Breast Cancer Awareness on the Couch. If you have a story you would like to talk about, you are more than welcome to come talk about it. I do have more to the story, so don't go anywhere. Follow Couch Chronicles No Limits on Spotify, Pandora, THA Couch on Facebook and TikTok, Couch Chronicles No Limits on Instagram, and my main YouTube Instagram, and my .com, which is THA Real JANELL. If you're watching on YouTube, make sure that you hit the like button. If you're watching on Instagram or Facebook, share the live. If you're listening on Spotify or Pandora, make sure that you subscribe. Tell your people, y'all can still subscribe to the Spotify and Pandora because this is the second season, episode 153. So I'm sure that there's some episodes that you do need to catch up on. Okay. If you're tuning in, make sure that you drop those ribbons for breast cancer awareness. It's Breast Cancer Awareness on the Couch. Now, I do have a song that I found for breast cancer awareness. Now, it's a country song, and I really love it. And I do want to share it. And it does not belong to me. So Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, this next song does not belong to me. But it's a beautiful song, and it's definitely for survivors. And it's from Martina McBride. If you guys don't know who she is, please look her up. This song is I'm Gonna Love You Through It. And this is for all the survivors. If you're watching, if you get this, please, this is from the Couch. We love you so much. And we are sending all the positive vibes, love, and energy and strength your way. Share the life.
She dropped the phone and burst into tears. The doctor just confirmed her fears. Her husband held it in and held her tight. Cancer don't discriminate or care if you're just 38 with three kids who need you in their lives. He said, I know that you're afraid and I am too, but you'll never be alone, I promise you. When you're weak, I'll be strong. When you let go, hold on. They caught it just in time, but they had to take more than they planned. And now it's four smiles and baggy shirts to hide what the cancer took from her. And she just wants to feel like a woman again. She said, I don't think I can do this anymore. Took her in his arms and said, that's what my love is for. When you're weak, I'll be strong. When you let go, I'll hold on. And when you need to cry, I swear that I'll be there to dry your eyes. When you feel lost and scared to death, like you can't.
Again, that song does not belong to me. That's Martina McBride. It's I'm Gonna Love You Through It. That's for all the survivors that is watching right now. If you're a survivor and you get to see this, please know that I'm sending all my love to you right now. To finish up my story, I do remember, you know, when I was younger, I remember crying on my mom's scar. You know, just believing that my tears would, you know, grow her breast back. I know it was stupid to think like that. But as a kid, everything just, you think everything can create magic. You think your tears can make things grow, you know? And I literally thought that if I cried on my mom's scar, that her titty would grow back. So I remember just, you know, nights I would just lay on her, just crying, feeling her pain, and wondering if one day it was some way that I can take it away. You know, it was very tough, very, very tough. And I wasn't even the one that was going through it. It was my mom, you know, but it was my mom. You know, we don't want to see our moms going through it. We don't want to see, you know, especially something like that. Cancer is very serious. When I was in prison, I do remember my mom actually got her breast, you know, reconstructed. And that was also painful for her, just watching her go through that as well. And it was like, oh my God, it was... Like, damn if you do, damn if you don't. But, you know, what they did was they put like this little bubble thing that was inside of her skin, and they had to stretch the scar out. And stretching the scar out, and they also had to build a nipple. And by building a nipple, I want to say they cut a piece of, I think either your ass off or maybe your leg, a piece of your leg. But, they literally reconstructed into another titty. And, you know, that alone, she went through that. And, you know, it was times that she couldn't come visit me because she was in a lot of pain, or, you know, risk of infection because she had, you know, the bandage and everything. So, you know, it caused a lot of pain as well. But in the long run, I want to say she feels better about herself. I can tell she has more confidence than what she used to. You know, back in when I was growing up, she used to just be, it was more of, she was more tomboyish. She didn't really step into her feminine side until like shortly, I want to say after. Yes, shout out to Australia. Shout out to everybody that's tuned in. Shout out to all the survivors. Shout out to everybody that's... If it's your first time tuning into The Couch, shout out to you. It's The Couch Chronicles and there ain't no fucking limits. If you didn't know, I do this every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday from 8 Central Time. It's Breast Cancer Awareness on The Couch. So don't be alarmed if you see these breasts covered up in these pink pieces of tape. Because, yeah, I can't do that part. But... my mom is a survivor. If you have a story and you would like to talk about it, even if you don't see these breasts and you would like to talk about it any time of this month on The Couch, you are more than welcome to come up on The Couch. If you would like to support The Couch, it's never mandatory, but it's always appreciated. You can cash at PayPal or Chime, T-H-A, real J-A-N-E-L-L, or you can send stars on Facebook. I want to send them stars, baby. Or you can send gifts on Big O. Also, you can follow The Couch on Big O. Obviously, they shut me down because the breast was a little bit too much for Big O today. So, that's just fine. If you guys didn't know, Breast Cancer Awareness Month started in 1985 as a partnership between the American Cancer Society and the pharmaceutical division. Betty Ford helped kick it off, and it was a week-long event. You can do more research on your own. But if you didn't know, that is some news you can use from the couch. Also, breast cancer awareness is to help educate the public about the symptoms, preventions, to fund research into the causes, treatment, and for a cure. Now, for those that are affected, this is for times, like this is a time that you can reflect on, you know, what you've been through, to also share your story to help somebody else. Also reflect on the ones that we've lost. And also, hey wifey, and also, I love you. And also the ones that are still here, that has survived. So definitely want to give them a shout out, everybody. Right, ain't no fucking limits, baby. None. Definitely want to give them a shout out. If you have, you know, like I said, a story that you would like to share, you are more than welcome to come onto the couch and talk about it. Not only was my mom, you know, affected with breast cancer, but, you know, both my grandmothers passed away from breast cancer. So it is really, really common in my family, you know, so we always do everything we can to stay safe. So if it's more common in your family, do everything you can to stay safe, meaning be aware, know your body, do a regular check on your body before and after your period, you know, and I say that because your period can cause changes in your breasts already. So you probably like, oh my God, is it not? No, baby. You're on your period. It's normal. But if you don't know, so you can do a self-exam. And the way you do that is I like to lift my arm all the way up like this and try to touch like the back of my shoulder blade. And I start from under my arm and I like to just, you know, you take your fingers like this, and I like to do it like this, but I like to start all the way down, you know, just in case, all the way down and around. You want to do it all the way around.
What are we feeling for?
We are feeling for lumps.
Okay.
So, what you're doing is you're feeling for any lumps, any changes, anything different. You know, you're going to feel all the way around until you get to your nipple. And then you're going to, you know, push in. Now, this is just a self-exam. I would still suggest you go get a mammogram. Now, if you are in fear that you don't have any money for a mammogram, because mammograms do cost. They do cost. Let's see. $95 to $231. So, if you don't have any insurance, that's the cost of it without insurance. Now, I know that might seem like much, but what is $95 to $291 for your health to be good? It should be nothing. It should cost nothing, you know, to make sure that you're good. But there are places that offer free mammograms. You just have to know where to search. If you are on food stamps, free mammogram. You get a free mammogram. If you're a man, you get a free prostate check. Like, look into that. Take advantage of that. A lot of men don't have... Did you know... I don't know if I said... I did say this earlier, but I'm going to say it again. Men could get breast cancer too. So you want to get checked. You want to get checked. You want to make sure that you're good. You know, like I said, especially if it runs in your family. I don't know if you guys know this, but the original color of the breast cancer ribbon was originally peach. It was originally peach. Now, they use it to hand out information and raise awareness back in the day, and eventually it turned into a bright pink. And they, all over, they adopted a pink ribbon as, you know, the national symbol for breast cancer awareness. So, again, if you just now tune in, make sure that you drop those pink ribbons for breast cancer awareness, because, like I said, it's Breast Cancer Awareness Month this whole month. It's all about love, support, good vibes, and positive energy. If you know a survivor, shout them out. If somebody in your family is a survivor, shout them out. I'm shouting out my mom, okay? She's a survivor. 26 years, you know? It takes a strong person to survive and to actually fight that fight. Because a lot of times, you see even movies, you see stories, you hear of people that have, no matter what, cancer. Sometimes they get so discouraged of the treatments and what they have to go through and what they have to lose that they don't even want to fight that fight. They don't even want to fight that fight. So I commend anybody that fights that fight and doesn't stop. And even if you, look, and like I said, again, you know, our heart goes out to anyone who's lost their life because they couldn't handle, you know, that fight. And not everybody can. And it's, I'm not going to say it's nothing wrong with it. But it's no judgment this way. It's no judgment this way because, again, we hear stories, we see movies of people who couldn't handle cancer or just the fact of losing anything. And a woman having to lose their breast is very, very traumatic. Especially a double mastectomy is very traumatic, you know? Just, my heart goes out to everyone. So, I love y'all. Also, like I said, do your self-exam in the shower. Do it in your bed. Do it before you start your period, after you start your period. Listen, again, women and men. If you guys didn't hear that song from Martina McBride, I'm going to leave it in the description because that song is really, really good. A quote for you guys, for all the survivors that's watching, make sure that you share this for every survivor that you know. It's, you're braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, smarter than you think, and twice as strong as you could ever imagine. Period. Y'all, if you just now tuning in, it is the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. You guys, if you're looking to get a mammogram and you need information on it, I also will be posting that. OU Breast Health, if you guys are in Oklahoma. Matter of fact, wherever you are located, if you don't want to do the research yourself, comment your state, and I will find out where you can get a free mammogram. Just comment your state. I will do the research for you. If you're in Oklahoma, OU Breast Health Network Outreach Program provides no-cost screening. Hey, love. No-cost screening. So if you are looking to get a mammogram, if you're looking for all the information, I don't care what state you're in. If you don't want to do the research yourself, please send me what state you're in, and I'll send you all the information that you need. Okay? It's Breast Cancer Awareness on the Couch. Make sure you drop those pink ribbons. It's the Couch Chronicles. And it ain't no fucking limits. Y'all know I got another song for y'all. Might as well play it from my next album that's coming up. So, the next one. Oh, I can't see from a distance. Let's just play Can't Make This Up. Yes, exactly. If you're watching on Instagram, share the live. If you're watching on YouTube, hit the like button. If you're watching on Facebook, share the live. If you listen on Spotify Pandora, shout out to you. I love y'all. This is from my new album coming up. Let's get into the vibe.
And I know it's really hard to keep your head up. And you've been working every day to get your bread up. It's even lonely at the top and now you're fed up. This shit is crazy, you go through, but you can't make this shit up. I'm supposed to always tell the truth. I cross my heart and hope to die. This shit is crazy, what I go through. I can't make this shit up.
No, I can't make this shit up.
I said that there are people that fight, and there are some people who don't want to fight when it comes to having breast cancer. And I had, you know, I had someone in my family, my grandmother on my dad's side, my dad's mom, she didn't want to fight. She was the one that was like, if I got breast cancer, I just got breast cancer. Fuck it. If this is what's going to take me out, it's what's going to take me the fuck out. And she lived her life all the way up until it took her. She did what she wanted to do. She didn't really give a fuck about anything or anyone or what anybody thought as far as, you know, how they thought she was handling her disease. She took it the way she took it, and she handled it the way she handled it. Now, when I was younger, I don't know if I was really upset. I think I just really didn't understand. I just didn't understand, like, how come, you know, she didn't want to fight? Was it because, you know, you didn't love us enough to fight and be around us? Or I didn't know. Like, I was conflicted. I was young. I was a kid. And that was my, because I didn't really get to have a good relationship with my mom's mom, because she had breast cancer, had took her away, and she died in my room. So now, I'm going to get into that in a minute. Whew, I'm trying not to cry. But, so, my dad's mom, I was really tight with her. I loved her. You know, she always had my back. You know, so I was just like, damn, why you don't want to survive? And I didn't say it to her. I didn't question what she told me. I didn't question what she said. You know, I just, hey, it is what it is. Only thing I can do is just understand, try to understand. So, my grandma on my dad's side, she died while I was locked up still. And I didn't get a chance to say goodbye. I didn't get a chance to anything. For a long time, I was angry with her after she passed away. But I had to come to grips with, I can't be mad at the dead. What the fuck that look like? So I had to let it go. My grandma left me, but she didn't have to leave me. She could have kept fighting. But I know she's looking up at me. I know y'all probably like, looking up from hell? Yes, I love you, Grandma. No, I'm playing. I don't know where she at. I love you though, Grandma. No, for real. I do. I love you, Grandma. Wherever you're listening from. Oh, shit. It's the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. Now, my grandma on my mom's side, which does, my mom's mom. I didn't really get a chance to build a bond with her when she found out she was dying. She requested to fly from New York, from the Bronx, New York, to Oklahoma. We was living in Broken Arrow at the time. Actually, we was living in Tulsa. So she flew from Tulsa on hospice. And this next song I'm going to play is actually a Lance Hitch, Gorilla Zoe, and myself song. So that's the next song I'm actually going to play too. Let me go ahead and get that one ready. But my grandma came on hospice. And honestly, I didn't know what to think. I was 11, 12. I just knew that I gave my room up for my grandma. And so I would sneak in there, you know, because I wanted to just watch her. And I would just go in there and just talk. I knew she didn't respond to anybody. I watched her day in and day out not say anything except, So I knew she would never say anything to me. So I just would go in there and just talk to her and just, you know, random shit. And then she talked to me. I was the only one that my grandma talked to before she died. And she died in my room. Ooh. And even though I didn't have the same bond with her that my other family members did, that bond before she passed away, that meant everything to me. Because I was still a kid, you know. And she stayed in the Bronx, and we stayed in Oklahoma. So it was easy for them to have a relationship with her because they were so close. They, like, literally stayed, like, right up the fucking street. So it was easy for them to build a relationship with them, or with my grandma. And it wasn't that easy for me to build a relationship with her because it would just be over the phone. And what is a relationship over the phone? Y'all don't even like to do long-distance relationship with a lover, okay? So I just was like, you know, it was hard. And I was young, and I didn't take advantage of being on the phone with my grandma and building a relationship with her. I didn't know she was sick. But should it have mattered? I should have had wanted to just talk to my grandma. But I was a kid, and I wanted to do kid shit. And it didn't dawn on me until she was in my room dying. What an idiot. Like, what? Then it dawns on you. Oh, you should have built the relationship with your grandma. Yeah. So, that happened. But she fought. She fought. My grandma, Gina, fought. I love y'all, too. She fought in a hush. I just wish that she could have made it. So I could have had more time with her, you know. Let's get into this next song, y'all. If you just now tuning in, it's the Couch Chronicles and it ain't no fucking limits. I do this every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday from 8 Central Time. Follow Couch Chronicles No Limits on Spotify, Pandora, THA Couch on Facebook, and TikTok. Couch Chronicles dot No Limits on Instagram and my main YouTube Instagram and my.com, which is THA Real JANELL. Shout out to everybody that's watching. It's Breast Cancer Awareness on the Couch. Make sure you drop those ribbons and them couches. Thank you. Thank you for the love, y'all. This next song I'm about to play is with myself, Lance Hitch, and Gorilla Zoe. Thank you so much. So we're going to get right into it.
Therapy helping. I've been thinking about increasing my sessions. Trying to find peace in these life's hard lessons. I ain't really me, goddamn it, I'm stressing. I don't want to spend this last $50 bill. Anything getting tight, and I know I gotta stretch it. I'ma go to church in the morning, cause I know that I've been praying, and I'm way past due for my blessings. Lord, could you please bend a couple rules for me? This world been cruel to me. When I show love, folks make a fool of me. Excuse who I choose to be. Really need a hug, but feeling like move for me. Cause all they are losing me. Who is it to trust? There for you. Usually, but I ain't in a mood to be. radio hospice. Feeling like going John Q on these doctors. Trying to tell me that I've been running out of options. I can take a lot, but not this, Lord, stop it. Weak in the mind, and I know the devil watching. Thinking of suicide, but know I gotta prosper. I act okay, thinking I deserve an Oscar. Ain't no way I could do it without the father. Back to the basics. My brother died and I couldn't take it. Forgive me for my sins, Lord, I still see faces. Aiming for the attic, but I'm trapped in the basement. Baptized, is it justified on your end? Or do I still got an answer to it in the end? Either way it go, I gotta take it on the chin. I've been praying for my wrongs, I'm just trying to make them
mad. Baby, I'm not okay. But I hope I'll forgive it, cause I will someday. I got a purpose in this. Somebody's blessing. Therapy helping. I've been thinking about increasing my session. Trying to find peace in these life taught lessons. I ain't really me, goddammit, I'm stressed. I don't wanna spend this last $50 bill. Everything getting tight and I know I gotta stretch it. I'ma go to church in the morning cause I know that I've been praying and I'm way past over my blessings.
Carried away to the world on my own. In a world where I do not belong. This pain is reserved for the strong. And I try to do it all alone. So we stand on. Ooh. It all for one. No, I want for all. How do you find your way when nights never turn to day? Stressed, but blamed by the best. We are like, fuck being okay.
Somebody's blessing. Therapy helping. I've been thinking about increasing my session. Trying to find peace in these life taught lessons. I ain't really me, goddammit, I'm stressed. I don't wanna spend this last $50 bill. Everything getting tight and I know I gotta stretch it. I'ma go to church in the morning cause I know that I've been praying and I'm way past over my blessings.
I don't mean to be a crybaby on the couch. I promise I don't. But to watch my grandma take her last breath, you know, to be right there, to be the only one that she talked to, it really did something to me, you know. And like I said, I was only like 11 or 12. And then shortly after that, I went to DHS custody. And then right after that, I went to prison, you know, so it was like, I never really got a chance, a real chance to grieve like everybody else did. I cried at the funeral, but like I said, I didn't really get a chance to understand. Yeah, exactly. You said that last conversation gave her peace. Yeah. Because shortly after that, she passed away. Yeah. So if you guys know anybody that is a survivor, y'all, it's breast cancer awareness this whole month. It's breast cancer awareness on the couch. Shout out to all the survivors. And like I said, if y'all didn't get a chance to watch the episode in the beginning, we gave a moment of silence to anybody that has lost their lives from breast cancer. Stay safe, stay aware. Like I said, if you need information, no matter what state you are in, please send me whatever state you're in, and I will find wherever your local free mammogram, place is. I got you. I will get everything taken care of. Your girl got you. I love y'all so much. I will see y'all tomorrow with a top on. I love y'all. It's the Couch Chronicles, and it ain't no fucking limits. Ew. Love you, wifey.